live on Austin City Limits Radio. Barnes Courtney.
She came to me in robes of white. In the corner of my room, a specter of the night, silhouetted by the moon, we're floating fast over traffic lights, bearing down on blackened sky, and colors burst as I close my eyes. Ooh, she said, lay me down in golden dandelions. Moment of my life, follow me into the dark. Ooh. She said, lay me down in golden dandelions. I've been waiting, a thousand pictures in my mind, in a painting of the past, I'm brushing over lines, and I'll paint them all again. We're floating fast over traffic lights, bearing down on blackened sky, and colors burst as I close my eyes. Ooh, she said, lay me down in golden dandelions. Moment of my life, follow me into the dark. Ooh. She said, lay me down in golden dandelions. I've been waiting, in art we're bright, in the candlelight, now we'll cradle all these memories to the end. And she said, lay me down in golden dandelions, 'cause I've been waiting for this moment all my life. Follow me into the dark. Ooh. She said, I've been waiting. Thank you very much. Let me introduce to you my friend, colleague, and lover, Agam Timur, everybody. I don't know why you're laughing. He's a very sultry character. I think you should all be jealous or impressed, or a mixture of the both. His beard feels like spun silk. Honestly, you should try it. Very soothing on your thighs. We are live on the radio. Right.
Hot, strung, young, and dumb, yeah, we had no fear. Way back when we said we'd both be millionaires. Now those days are over, and we're all ghosts. We used to sleep all day, talk all night, stay up by the TV light, oh. Wipe the stardust from your eyes, oh. Said, come on, love will be just fine. We're gonna live just like it's 1999. In 1990. In 1999. Tonight, back then we were trading cards behind the swings. Oh no, now it's money, gold and diamond rings. Now those days are over, we're all ghosts. We used to sleep all day, talk all night, stay up by the TV light. Stardust from your eyes. Oh, said, oh, come on, love will be just fine. We're gonna live just like it's 1999. Does it go? Well, whatever fill your body up with chemicals. Oh no, kaleidoscopes. Well, whatever living better. Oh, oh, in 1990, in 1999.
Thank you.
Barnes Courtney live on Austin City Limits Radio. We know you as one of our more colorful returning guests.
And friend yet, of the trees, forgiver of children.
All of those. Yet you're a little bit of a disappointment. You're
sound just like my mom.
You would be an excellent presence on the Twitter.
Ah, the Twitter.
And you have the Twitter, but it's always, hey, I'm playing Dallas, or, oh, you were great, Houston, or, hey, I'm playing this festival. If there's somebody born to do this, to tweet out interesting little life-on-the-road tidbits from a twisted angle, that's you. You afraid of it? What's your deal?
Yeah. Oh, so, man, you're coming right out of the gate with the questions. Like a tiger of the radio. Barnes, explain to me the inner workings of your fears and insecurities. Are they expressed through your Twitter behavior? My psychologist says it is. Yeah, you know what? I think I like the presence of an audience or someone in front of me to talk to. And when I'm on the internet, it's like this cold, soulless tube that I like have access. And I heard that. Do you ever hear that story about the woman who said all that stuff about AIDS? And then she was on this flight to Africa and she didn't look at her phone again for like 24 hours. And when she did, she'd lost her job and her husband left her. And she kind of, you know, degenerated into a complete shell of a woman. So that, yeah. So yes, in answer to your question, I think I am scared.
Now, Instagram, on the other hand, my impression of you on Instagram is just shirtless photos of you stage diving.
What's wrong with that? You don't enjoy shirtless photos of me stage diving? Maybe you don't. It sounds like you were on there enough to know that I'm always posting shirtless photos stage diving.
How dangerous is the stage diving bit? How is you? You broke. How did you do that? When you a couple of years ago, you broke something. Was
yeah.
that stage diving?
No, not as such. It okay. was. It wasn't like one of those, you know, School of Rock Jack Black moments where like you leap off stage and everyone moves out of the way. I mean, it was more that like the audience was like 300 feet away. And I don't know why they put them so far back. And it was a big festival. It was Summerfest. And I kind of like leapt off the stage at the last song to become closer with the people who had come to the show, not realizing that there was concrete down there. Because before that point, I kind of like just in my head, I had never really vocalized it to myself or others, that I kind of felt like I was immortal and that I would never succumb to any kind of bodily harm or to like the grip of the Reaper or anything like that. And it turned out that was very much wrong.
there is traditionally this exchange of energy between a performer and an audience. When you go into the crowd, does that intensify when they're touching you, lifting you up?
It intensifies for them when I'm rubbing my sweaty head all over their... Please, I only came for El King. Leave me alone. Why are you doing this? Leave me and my daughter alone. Look, give me that fire. Can I sing along? Woo!
But that's why you do it.
Yeah, you know, I just have a penchant for rubbing my bodily fluids on unsuspecting people in the audience. Is that so wrong? Worked a long time to get to this level.
Saw the van when you pulled in.
Yeah.
You've got right there on the grill a Chewbacca face mask.
Yeah. You going to call me up on that too? Got a problem with that as well?
No.
Let's get it all out.
I think it's a touching tribute to a departed Wookiee.
Oh, I forgot about that. Yeah. Oh, way to bring down the mood.
Wait, was that up before he was dead?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's been up there for a long time. And then we take it off each van and then reaffix it to the new one.
Because you're a Star Wars geek or because...
No,
because
I'm super cool. And I mean, yeah, I do like Star Wars, but I also lift a lot of weights. I mean, you can't say... It's like a lot of core muscle stuff mainly.
We were talking beforehand. You have come through here in basically every configuration. You've done our Dell Music Lounge. You've played for us during South by Southwest, bright and early in the morning.
And I know. You'd think I'd be famous by now, don't you? I thought that was the deal. I come and do all this stuff for you, and I play all the shows, and then I can stop and just do the drugs. That's the deal.
But this has been working out for you, and I that's where I was going, was that you've put in the work. And now things are happening.
Now look at me.
And now look at you.
Look at me now.
In the same place you were, right back in this.
Same place I have.
Are you seeing that payoff, though, each night?
I mean, this in and of itself is a payoff, isn't it? You know? I was complaining to my manager a couple months ago. Like, you know, man, it's taken a very long time. And I thought the last single would have done better. And he's like... He's got this weird accent. It's like an amalgamation of English and Australian for some reason, because he kind of lived around America and England. He said, you know, Bones, he's a big, bald, Cockney guy. He says, you know, Bones, you could be, right, the regional manager of a bleach company in southern England, right? And right now we could be on our way to meet with HQ about the new brand of toilet duck. You understand? I was like, yeah, I gotcha. I think this isn't a job, is it? It's not really work. Is this work?
It's work for me today. El King, not an easy person to tour with. There's a lot going on.
Yeah, she's a very, very nice lady. And I would never say anything about her that would get me kicked off that tour.
I don't think there's anything you could say that would get you kicked off that tour.
No, she's lovely. Yeah, she's rock and roll, that lady. You know? She's like a quivering maelstrom of energy. It's beautiful.
And those crowds, you can see when they connect with you?
Yeah, I mean, it hasn't happened yet, but I... I imagine I'll be able to see it. I got in trouble a lot on this tour, like a lot.
Four. Give us an example.
Taking my pants off, which is something I do. They called up my manager. My agent got on the phone. It got like a really big deal. They called up my manager. We're like, he's taking his pants off on stage. My manager goes, right. Is that all? Because it usually takes a lot more than that. Al's tour manager came and threw my pants at me. You can't keep your pants on stage. Really, Barnes? There are children out there. Which, of course, triggers, like, every naughty schoolboy, like, tendency of me ever. I was like, well, somebody's got to teach him, you know? Who better than their old Uncle Barnesy?
Did you go to school in America or England?
Both.
Okay.
Yeah.
When you were getting in trouble for being the class cut-up, that was both.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I've never been very good in school. I do like to learn things, you know. I watch the pod, the, you know, listen to podcasts and watch YouTube videos about Admiral Nelson, and he was a good dude. I mean, I have more to say than that.
That's why I'm standing here silently.
Yeah, you know. What, is this a report now? Is this an essay? Or... He did an amazing thing in the last battle of his career, where usually, like, all the ships, the old-timey ships, would line up sequentially with each other and fire all their cannons. And Nelson's like, well, look, I'm Lord Nelson. I'm super famous. I got an eye patch. He's like, I'm getting old, so I need to make this my signature battle. So he got all his ships into two columns and attacked the French simultaneously in like a sort of double-pronged, like Nelson snake fang attack kind of deal, right? And he's in the front ship. Everyone's like, Nelson, are you crazy? What are you doing? Like, you're the jet. You need to keep your brains at the back so you can organize things. And he's like, no, listen, I'm going to be super cool in the history books. Everyone's going to see me in my awesome hat. I'm going to be right at the front. So he does this thing, and it works. It's a tremendous success. And then he gets shot in the chest and buried in this enormous cathedral, St. Paul's in England. And everyone's lining the streets. And oh, poor Nelson. His only request was they look after his beautiful wife and daughter, which, of course, they didn't. And they ended up very poor and alone. Nailed it. And you all doubted me.
Maybe it's okay he doesn't tweet. So, should we care about this royal baby as somebody who lived over there?
There is a royal baby, isn't
there? As of this morning.
I don't know. I mean, I like babies. You know, you should be happy that, well, maybe not, because the world's desperately overpopulated.
And finally, what's the state of this new album situation?
I mean, you know, I just keep saying it's done, and they keep giving me money, so... Yeah, so, no, it's finished.
But we're going song by song at this point until we get word of a record.
I went out to, I convinced the record label that I needed to be in a chateau to finish the album. I was like, I can't do it without being in a chateau. I mean, so we went out to Carmel, this beautiful winery, and I did nothing for the entire month that I was there. But I mean, it was amazing, and I drank a lot of good wine, and crashed a golf cart. Into a fountain, which has long been a dream of mine.
Pants on or off?
I don't see how that's relevant to this conversation. How I was dressed is relevant to this conversation about my album. And what were you wearing at the time, Barnes?
Once again, live on Austin City Limits Radio, Barnes Courtney.
I could see the city written in your face. Freckles spread like constellations all over the place. Well, I could kiss you through the night, begging you to never go home. Staring at your photograph and singing to you down the telephone. So if you're struggling to go to sleep tonight, when you're on your own beneath the lonely lights, oh darling, if I ever cross your mind, won't you let me know? Oh, it's hard, oh, it's hard to be alone. Oh, it's hard, oh, it's hard to be alone. Moved to the big city and called it home. Oh, what a crowded place to live alone. When she was a quiet girl when we were young. What have we done? What have we done? Ooh, 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 you're struggling to go to sleep tonight, when you're on your own beneath the lonely lights. Oh, darling, if I ever cross your mind, won't you let me know? Oh, it's hard, oh, it's hard to be alone. Oh, it's hard, oh, it's hard to be alone.
Thank you. Yeah, way to bring the mood down, Barnes.
Lonely shadows following me. Lonely ghosts come calling. Lonely voices talking to me. Now I'm going, I'm going, I'm going. Told me, son, let it be. Sold my soul to the calling. Sold my soul to sweet melody. Now I'm going, I'm going, I'm going. Lord, give me that fire. Staring at me, thousand times I've fallen, thousand voices dead at my feet. Now I'm going, I'm going, I'm going. And my mother told me, son, let it be. Sold my soul to the calling. Sold my soul to a sweet melody. Now I'm going, I'm going, I'm going. Lord, give me that fire. Devils come calling, calling my name out, lost in the fire. Sweet virgin, your blood is calling, calling my name out, lost in the fire. Lord, give me that fire.
Thank you.